Hello everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening for everyone who are joining from different locations. So let me welcome you all for this webinar. So this is API Manager 400 introduction webinar. So my name is Sanjeev Mahagoda. I'm working as a software architect and the associate director of engineering at WSO2. And I'm primarily work for WSO2 API Manager team. And overlooking the research and development side of the WSO2 API Manager product. So in this webinar, we will mainly cover API Manager 400 new features and the rationale behind doing API Manager 400 release. So so we have combined WSO2 API Manager and Integration Server with this release, and we have added some exciting new features, and our cloud analytics strategy is something very interesting. So I'll be covering these things in this webinar. And if you have any questions, please use the Q&A section to ask them. So towards the end of webinar, I'll be taking them one by one and answering them. So if we got more questions, we will formulate answers and send them back with you the webinar recording and other email that we send after the webinar. So so if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them in the Q&A section. So in this webinar, I'll discuss about WSO2 API Manager 4.0. And why we decided to do that release, and what is the rationale behind API Manager and the Enterprise Integration Merge. And then I will discuss about new features. Then after discussing these things, I will walk you through API Manager 400. So basically, I'll walk you through user interfaces of ISTO Publisher and the admin UIs and explain new changes and how these things going to affect to you all. Okay, so to start, let me give you a quick understand about WSO2. So WSO2 is one of the leading integration company. So here we have 750 plus employees, and majority of them are engineers. And almost all the products that we release so far are open source, and we have like 500 different customers covering different industry verticals. And we founded in 2005, and we are like reaching 50 million USD ARR. Okay, so if we discuss about our presence across the world, we have deployed our solutions in 75 plus countries, and with the 150 plus partner network, we address almost all the territories, and we cater all the integration demands. Okay, so if you look at the products and the solutions and the services that we were offering over last 2 years, so we have as of today we have three main products: WSO2 API Manager, WSO2 Enterprise Integrator, and the WSO2 Identity Server. So later this session, I'll discuss what is the merge, what we have done with this release, and why we decided to merge WSO2 API Manager and Integration Enterprise Integrator. So then on top of these integration product and the identity products, we have built some industry specific technical verticals. So those are WSO2 Open Banking, which serves open banking demands. And then we have another one called Open Healthcare Solution, which address healthcare related requirements and the integration demand. Then we do strategical consultancy as well. So these are our main offering as of today from WSO2 side. Okay. So if I discuss about WSO2 API Manager, then as WSO2 API Manager, we were catering almost all the API management demands we have today. So we manage full API lifecycle, and we do have gateway component, and then we do have necessary components to build the API marketplaces. So you are catering almost all the API management demands with WS2 API Manager product, right? So if you look at core competencies we have in WS2 API Manager, then you know API gateway component is there, which take care about the policy enforcement, the protocol handling, transformation, that part. And also it's not just only API gateway, there's a micro gateway component that as well, which is most suitable for cloud native environment. So then if you look at the security pillar, then we do support different security protocols. We do support OAuth 2 for API security, OIDC, and the portals, we support SSO, we do support JWT, and then we do have AI-driven API security plugin capabilities as well. So then, if you look at the analytics side of things, then we do support business value reporting, streaming and data-driven analytics, real-time alerting, traffic management, and if you have a monetization requirement, then we do cater them as well. Then, like I mentioned earlier, these products are cloud native, so we do support different CI/CD pipelines and different the cloud related engagements and the deployment options, right? So then if you look at the portal and the store side, then we do have all the components that are required to build API marketplace or the large API stores. And then we do have API monetization support as well. And the flexible theme-based architecture is also available. Okay. Okay. So then the other product. So if you look at enterprise integrator side, this is primarily in integration platform. So basically with this, you can do microservice integration, and if you have like a traditional enterprise service bus related requirement, then we do have that support as well. And if you have streaming integrators integration requirement, which is like you need to expose your streams to outside as a service, then we do support that as well. So, and also in within the enterprise integrator, we do have like different connectors which allows you to plug in your system into external SaaS and proprietary system. And that way you can easily integrate with them and pull and push data and expose your services to outside, right? So, and in addition to that, we did that monitoring and then visual editing tool also there. So these are the two main products we were offering related to integration requirement. And most of our customers, they start with the both side. So some of our customers and users start with API management. Then later, when they have integration requirement, they start with integration development. So some of our customers and users, they start with the integration part because they have like different backend systems. They need to connect them together and expose that as a service. So they always start with the integration part. And at some point, they need to expose their services to outside as managed API. At that point, they start using WS2 API Manager. So we have seen these two patterns, and most of the time, people are using them together. So the rationale behind moving API Manager 4.0.0 with both these platforms is most of our customers are using these two products together. And like we can use them together to build almost all the integration demand, including the API management. So that is the main idea behind merging them together. So with this, we have included three profiles into our product, API Manager 4.0.0. That is API Manager and the Micro Integrator and the Streaming Integrator. So all these three profiles now part of WS2 API Manager 4.0.0. Okay, so if you look at the component architecture of WS2 API Manager 4.0, this is some diagram we can explain easily. So in your left side, you see different tooling. So these tools are the tools that you use to design, develop, and deploy your APIs and integration. So in your right left side, you see different IDE plugins, API controller, and the integration studio. Then we have streaming editor. Then we have Kubernetes controller. So all these things we can use to design, develop, and deploy your integration services and the APIs. So then we have a management plane. So in a management plane, we basically have stuff that we use to manage these integrations, APIs that you develop. So that's include developer portal, service catalog, and the API publisher, analytics, and the API operator. So these are like management pieces of the API Manager 4.0. So then next, you can see data plane. So data plane include API gateway, which mainly responsible for intercepting incoming API calls and apply quality of services. So then next you see integration layer. So in the integration layer, we do request response level architecture integration and also streaming integration as well. And in your right side, you see control plane. So control plane means how we can control these things. So that's include the traffic management component, which will take care about your like traffic shape up and the access, detecting access patterns, controlled access. And then we have key manager component, which take care about the, all the security aspect, authentication, authorization, that will be take care about key manager side. And also then there are like some AI driven capabilities like anomaly detection and honeypot detection. Those things are also there, right? So that's about the control plane of side. So together all these components, we can address all the integration demand towards the bottom of this image. You see different SaaS systems, proprietary, even message bus, and if you have microservices or even data, you can interact with these different systems and expose this data to outside as secured APIs or the integration service. So that is the idea of API Manager 4.0. So then API Manager 4.0 will be like open source approach for full lifecycle API management, integration, and the streaming. And like all our previous releases, this is again complete open source, and it support end-to-end lifecycle management, security, monitoring and monetization, and these products or the profiles you can deploy on-premise, cloud, or as hybrid option. So all these things are supported as you were doing before. Okay, so next I'll discuss a little bit about the new features. So in the demonstration, I'll demonstrate how these new features work together and how they can ease your life. In this section, I will quickly walk you through them, right? So if you look at the main new features, first one is the service catalog. So service catalog is how you can build the connectivity between integration services and the API management, right? So basically how these things can connect. So in the next slides, I will explain these new features in detail. And the next feature is API product revision support. So basically how you can like separate API development and deployment part, and then carefully deploy specific revision instead of updating entire API. So that is again, I will discuss in detail. So then we do have streaming API integration support and the async API support. So then if you're using WSO2 API Manager previous versions, you know, you can connect external key management components into WSO2 API Manager. So this time we are expanding. So we were supporting KeyClock and Okta. So in this release, we have expanded that, and we implemented the support for another three new key manager connectors. So then we have done some improvements related to user experience. So basically to improve the user experience when they interact with API publisher and the developer portal. And like I mentioned in the beginning, from this release onward, we have moved our analytics into cloud. So that will be another thing we need to discuss in detail. So then we have custom API hostname feature. Then there are some improvements we have done related to micro gateway. So now let's have a look at on these features in detail. So the first one is service catalog for integration, right? So service catalog means when you create new integration service, you can create entry. So if you look at the business requirement of this service catalog is, so in your environment, you may create different integration services, right? So for example, if you need to have some sort of a message conversion, then what you will be doing is you create integration service to cater that demand. So with this service catalog, when you create new service and when you deploy that, that will create entry in the service catalog, and that help API manager to auto discover about these services. And then when you create API, you can easily see already available services and pick one of them and create API. So that way, we believe integration developers and the API management API developers can work together very easily, and the smooth integration happen between these two teams. While doing the demonstration, I will show how this works. And the next one is revision support. So if you look at the business requirement of the revision support, so if you're using the previous versions or the other products, so most of the time you create API, you deploy that API at once, and then every time when you publish or do change to API, that particular change will get effective gateway as well. So with this release, we have separated API development and the deployment part. So you can keep developing your API, but still the artifact that you deployed in the gateway won't change with every change you do, right? So when you want to deploy a specific revision into gateway, what you can create is cut a branch of current API status and deploy that selectively to a specific gateway. And in the future, if you feel at any point, okay, this revision went wrong and something, this revision deployment, you can always fall back to previous revision. So while doing demonstration, next import. So async API, yes, and we have observed people are like using different protocols, and they are heavily using async API definition to define APIs. So with that in mind, we decided to provide full async API support. So basically, with this API Manager 4.0, we are having streaming integrator component, which you can use to integrate with the streams or the different messaging systems. And then you can expose these streams or the data to outside as async API. So basically, in this release, we do support different protocol, three different protocols as initial implementation. And we hope to support more and more streaming APIs and the API protocols in the future. So basically, so this is not something of course, and we try to provide as much as native capabilities that we need when it comes to authentication, authorization, and the other quality of services. So in this initial version, we will be supporting WebSocket, webhook, and the SSE. As you can see in this diagram, you can have a streaming provider. It can be any streaming provider. It can be WSO2 streaming integrator, or it can be any other one which expose these streaming services. So then you can use WSO2 API gateway to apply quality of services, authentication, authorization, rate limiting, that sort of quality of services for your streaming APIs. So basically, hope you all can see my screen, okay?
Yes.
Okay. So as you can see in this diagram, your clients will interact with API gateway, and API gateway will intercept the flow and apply these quality of services. Okay, so now different key manager connector support. So like I mentioned earlier, we were supporting KeyClock and Okta. So from this release onward, we will be supporting ForgeRock, OAuth0, and the ping identity. So that means, so if you have any of these identity providers in your environment, then most probably you won't need to write any code. You can simply use our product and do some UI level configurations to configure and work with these identity providers. Okay, so then custom hostname feature. So this is again kind of important feature, and we have observed some of our customers have requirement to expose these APIs through the vHost. So this is to natively support that part. So we can discuss about this also later. And then, like I mentioned earlier, API publisher and the developer portal, we did a considerable amount of changes just to make API developers and the API consumers life easy. So while doing the demonstration, I can show how these UIs are restructured. But if I tell like the idea behind this one, so we, in the publisher side, we have structured publisher flows to route user to a specific flow, that is develop, deploy, test, and the publish flow. So basically you start with API development, then you deploy your API into runtime, then you test that flow, then finally you publish your API. So that is the user journey in terms of the publisher side. So we have restructured some of the UI component and reordered some of them to cater this demand. And if you look at the API developer portal side, then again, you can see there are some improvements we have done to make the API consumers life easy, just like one-click API consumption. So with just one click, you can subscribe to API, generate keys, and you can start using API. So these are kind of like enhancement we did on top of our React UIs. Okay, so then another important thing is cloud analytics. So over last few years, we were providing API Manager analytics pack, so that you need to download and you can install that within your data centers. And then you can configure API Manager to work with analytics. So that publish event to analytics, and then you can generate the summary and you can see the reports. So that that's something we were supporting. So with this release, when our customers do that, they face some challenges. So these challenges including like maintaining large data volume. Sometimes they had to configure like data purging tasks. So that was kind of a trouble for them. So there were some requests from our different customers and users asking whether this solution can be provided as a cloud solution. So to address that demand, we have moved our analytics into cloud. So basically from this release onward, you can configure cloud account and you can get the key. You can embed that key into your API Manager runtime. Then you can deploy and deploy your APIs. Then it will automatically communicate with the cloud and publish all your events to cloud. So basically you don't have to do anything. So when you configure the key, your API Manager instance know how to connect to cloud, and you can see your graph, alerts, and everything on the cloud side. Okay, so these are some of the screenshots. While doing the demonstration, I'll show how you can use this. Okay. So I'll start my Docker runtime, because for the demonstration, I need this Docker. So next I'll discuss about the micro gate improvement. So if you are familiar with WSO2 API Manager, then you know we did offer a specific micro gateway version. So from API Manager 4.0 onward, we decided to go ahead with ONNOI proxy for micro gateway, which is we recommend for the cloud native deployment. So that you can deploy as a edge gateway or the shared API gateway. And this new micro gateway component having some different components. So these are like a router, which is ONNOI proxy, which will intercept the message and apply quality of services. So then we have some component called Enforcer, which will act as a filter and take care about the authentication, authorization, and that sort of interaction. And then we do have some component named Adapter, which will do the communication between the control plane and the API gateway. So basically, when you create API, that API will deploy it into your runtime using this adapter. So that's about the micro gateway. Okay, so then I'll discuss a little bit about the deployment patterns, because previously we were supporting different profiles. So ISTO, publisher, developer portal, key manager, and they are like different profiles. So with API Manager 4.0, we have made JWT as a default authentication type. So with that, we were able to remove the direct dependency between gateway and key manager. And likewise, there are some other changes also. So with that, we can go for very simple deployment compared to what we had before, right? So so this is how, if you look at the message flow between client application and your backend, this is how these components are placed and how it works. So basically, you can see your API gateway layer here, and you can see when you start development from the very beginning, and if your backends are under construction, then what you can do is that you can generate the mock response, and from your API, you can interact with them. And then if you have functional mediation layer, which is like calling multiple backends and generate aggregate response, then you will have your integration service here. Then you create API by pointing to your integration service. And the third option is, if you don't have any integration requirements, in that case, what you can do is that you can directly connect your APIs to your functional backend. So all these three models are supported. And based on your demand or the requirement, you can use any of these. Okay. So then if you look at the deployment, like I mentioned earlier, deployment, you can have simple deployment like this. So basically, you can have API Manager cluster, which is all in one, that will include the ISTO, publisher, gateway, key manager, all of them together. And then you can configure that cluster to work with micro integrator or the streaming integrator cluster, which can act as an integration cluster. Okay. So then if you look at distributed model, then you can see this kind of a deployment. So basically, you have control plane, which will take care about the ISTO, publisher, key management, all these operations we handle in the control plane side. Then we do have API gateway cluster as data plane, and also you can have integration cluster. So this kind of, with this sort of simple deployment, you can address distributed deployment. So if you go to our documentation, then we have explained the rationale behind moving this simplified deployment and the necessary components, how you can configure them, all this information available in our document. Okay, so with that, I'll be moving into demonstration. So I have started my Docker runtime. So I'll waiting to start that. Okay, so till that start, I will take few questions. Yeah. Okay, I'll take one question. So when send event from publisher to gateway environment, does the gateways write their own Synapse files? So with this API Manager 4.0.0, writing Synapse file is not needed. So all your API changes we load into runtime, and from the runtime we can serve the traffic. Okay, I'll mark that one. And there's another one. Can we use the mediation inside the APM to answer that? Yes, we were supporting mediation as we were supporting before. And if you have like a more complex integration requirement, then in that case, you can use integration service. Okay, so then there's another question. Okay, will it work with the previous version of analytics? To answer that question, answer is no. But if you have a specific integration with any external system like ELK stack or the Splunk or anything like that, so those extensions you can use as is, because the publishing part will only change, but the previous analytics won't work with this new version. Okay, so then can you further explain how new authentication flow will work with new JWT? So while doing the demonstration, I'll make a note and answer this question. So then there's another question. Is there a traffic manager in this version? If not, do the gateways communicate directly to share the traffic? So in this version also, we do have traffic manager, and it will keep throttling calculation and everything as you were having before. Okay, so then integration studio for MI is still not user friendly, and we will manually update it. So we have done some improvements, and we have released new integration studio version. I would like to welcome you to try that and give us your feedback. So Enterprise Integrator newest version is out, and you can download and you can use that with this API manager. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so I'll take a couple of more questions. So can I export analytics data for Prometheus and Grafana? And so if this question is about using Prometheus and Grafana with WSL API Manager 4.0.0, then yes, you can integrate them with this one. So the data publishing part, we can automate. So then can the extensions done for previous WS2P APM using Apache Synapse be reused? Yes, the answer is yes. So if you have any mediation extensions written in Synapse or any other way, class mediators or anything like that, so everything will be working without any issue. So, will the APM be completely okay? So this question is: will the APM 4 will completely remove, replace over the time for the EI product? So it's not we do not want to position that as a remove or replacement. So it's like so our customers and users are using this Enterprise Integrator and the API Manager together. So with this release, what we have done is we have like merged them together and offer joint support. So we don't have any plan to remove or duplicate EI. So we will keep supporting both and as a one single platform. Okay, so then there's another question. How will the analytics work when we have a hybrid cloud setup? So to answer that, so when you have like different deployments, you can generate different keys and embed them into your environment. So from this, each of these environment, when they publish events to cloud, we can detect this specific environment, and we can show analytics accordingly. So if it is whether it's a on-premise deployment, cloud one, or the hybrid one, it will work same way. Okay, so there's other question. So we are still on API Manager 2x version. Would you suggest to skipping 3x version? So my answer is, so if you have streaming integration or the this new feature requirement, then our recommendation is to always come to API Manager 4.0. And if in terms of the migration, if you directly move from 2 to 4, there's no any change. So we do provide all the artifact and we have tested those flows. So you can straight away move from API Manager 2x version to 3. But the only point I want to highlight is, so if you have done any customizations on our previous version, like early 2x versions, we did had jQuery-based UIs. So this new version, we have React API-based UIs. So if you have any customizations, be mindful about that. So other than that, I don't see any issue with directly moving to a new version. Okay, so upgrade from 3.2 to 4 is possible. The answer is yes. So migration resource available for that one. And if you have like any specific requirement related to migration, you can always contact us and get our help. Okay, so then there's a question about the what is the new API testing feature we introduced in the publisher side. So while doing the demonstration, I will show how that works. So like I mentioned earlier, we are routing our users in a specific flow to develop, deploy, test, and then publish flow, right? So that means in the publisher side itself, you can test your API. So as an API developer, you can start designing your API, then develop your API. And within the publisher itself, you can test your API and before move it into gateway. Okay, so so now my Docker setup is completed. So I can show how this new flow works. So if you go to API create wizard, then you will see, hope you can see my screen.
Yeah, we can see it.
So so when you create API, you will get multiple options. You can start with the REST API. You can start with the SOAP GraphQL. So this streaming API is a new section. So this is the one I discussed earlier, importing async API definition. So then this is the service catalog option I discussed before. So I'll start with the import open API option. So I'll pick this one. Thank you. Yeah, I'll create this API. Okay, so now this API created in our system, and then you can see different cases. So previously I explained we are like, from now on we are routing users through a specific journey. So they start with the API development, then go to deploy, then test, then publish, right? So in the development part, we have split into two parts. So first one is the portal configuration. So portal configuration includes the basic information. Basic information means who can see this API, what is the visibility, tags, API categories, GitHub URLs. So those things will be the basic information. So then you can provide business information. So basically, who is the business user of this API, that sort of information you can provide with this one. So then we have subscriptions. You can pick different subscription tiers here. Then you can attach document for your API. Then this API comment. So this API commenting is new feature. So basically you can comment about your APIs. At the same time, your API consumers can also comment about your APIs. And API, as API developer, you can reply to those comments. So that's about comment feature. I will show how this works next. So then we have a runtime configuration. So in this runtime configuration section, we have split into two parts, the actual three parts. So the request path, response path, and the fault path. We have separated these three for the ease of use. Then we have subcategorized them into transport level security, application level security, course configuration, schema validation, and the message mediation. So transport level security means whether you are gonna expose this as HTTP, HTTPS. If you need mutual SSL, then you can set them here. So then in the application level security, you can provide different security methodologies or to basic API key. And if you have multiple key managers, then you can select them separately. And you can change header name as well. And there was some question about mediation sequences. So so these mediation extensions are still available in the product. And if you have any custom sequence, we keep supporting them as well. Okay, so this is about the runtime. And this is the resource view. Then you can see API, open API definition here. You can change it if need. And this is the endpoint configuration. So here you can provide load balance, failover, different failover criteria, how you're going to suspend this API endpoints. So that sort of thing. So this is the scopes. And then here we have API properties. So if you are not satisfied with available properties, you can add new property. Then we can go to deployment. So like I said earlier, this deployment part is somewhat different. So in this case, initially we will have a default version. I'm going to deploy that with the default version. So it created the revision successfully. So you can see now we have revision one and it's deployed there, right? So and if you need to create another revision, what you can do is you can create revision two and select this gateway and deploy this two. Okay, so now new revision created and now live version is revision two. So likewise, you can go to API publisher, do any change, and without effect into deploy revision, you can deploy them to another gateway or another runtime without affecting running APIs. So this is the API revision feature. And like I mentioned earlier, at any point, if you think this revision 2 is problematic, you can always fall back to revision 1 with the restore option. Okay. So now I have completed my API design part, development part, and the deployment part is also completed. So now as API publisher, I need to test my API. So to do that, we have provided this new capability. This is the publisher tryout feature. So basically, it will generate a specific token for you to try out your API from the publisher itself. So this API is still not visible in the developer portal side, or the external people cannot see this API or use this API. So it's only you will see this API. Only you can consume this API. So like that, I have this test key. So with this test key, I can invoke and see how my API works. Okay. So with the test key, you can do some tests and verify how this works. So you get the response. So your backend work, now you are fully satisfied about your API. And finally, as a last option, you can go to publish and you have completed all the steps you need to publish API. Then you can publish your API, right? So now this API published. Now you can go and view this API in the portal side itself. You can see this in the developer portal. So this is your API. And with this one, you can, so previously I mentioned one click tryout thing. So this is how you click on this one. So then it will subscribe to this API, get the keys, and everything will be happen online. So now I'm getting a test key for this API. And now I can invoke this API. Okay. So now I consume this API, I get the response, I'm happy about this API, and if need, I can add comment. Okay, so I add my comment here, I reply. So and now if you go to publish again, in the publisher comment section, you will see this comment, and if need, you can reply to that also. So now I'll quickly move into async API side. So for this one, like I mentioned early, we do support PepsoCert, Webhook, and the SSE. I'll start with the async API definition. Click here, and I'm going to upload async API definition like this. So this is my async API file. I'll name, location, and the version. And as a protocol, I can use any of these. So it can be WebSocket, WebSub, or SSE. So once you click on this thing, it will ask for the endpoint. You can provide endpoint. So likewise, you can continue. So I have already created the train location API. So to that, I'll show. So this one, I have already created. And if you go to runtime, then you will see WebSocket URLs. That I provided here. So now when I need to try this API, I'll go to developer portal, and this is my train location API. And then I'll go to try out. Get new key. And generate curl, copy curl. So now I can invoke this API. So in the command line terminal, I entered this one. So you can see I'm getting WebSocket update related to this API, to the API manager. So now I expose this as a secured WebSocket API. And with the access token, I can invoke that API and get my responses there. Okay. So that's about async API support. So in this one, I'm going to demonstrate only WebSocket, but similar to that, if you have requirement to SSE or the web sub, you can use them as well. Okay, so then I'll show how you can configure the analytics or use analytics. So first, I'll go to this console.corio.dev. By the way, all these instructions available in the documentation. So if you go to analytics configure document, then you can see these instructions. So you can go here, you can sign up, and then you can create account. So I have created new account, and then go here, go to on-premise keys. And so here I have two environments, test and Sanjeev local. So I can create a new one. So if I have production deployment, then I'll create that, and then I generate the keys, and I'm going to copy this key. So only thing you need to do is copy this key and embed that into your API manager instance. So then once you start the service or the API gateway, it know how to connect with the cloud, and it will keep sending event to cloud. And then you can go to analytics.corio.dev. So once you go here, you will see your environments. Okay. So I had prod and test. I published data for both these. So then you can select a specific environment, and then you can select a time window. So for this one, I'm going to pick 30 days. And my environment, I'm going to select pod. So now you can see my graph and data being populated. So likewise, you can zoom and see how these APIs behave, and the total time latency. And if you want to see API-wise access details. You can select your APIs here. And if you want to see application level details, you can pick your applications here and then see how your API is being accessed from different levels, right? So then you can see API level stats, resource level stats, and even you can see errors. So in the error case, you can pick a specific category. So if you want to see only authentication errors, you can pick them and see how people invoke your APIs and get the errors. Then if it is a connectivity error, you can check them. And then based on the status code also, you can check errors. So likewise, there are different graphs available. And if you want to configure alerts for a specific requirement, then you can configure the alerts as well. So here I haven't configured any alert, that's why you see it. And then you can download these reports for the later use. For example, if I want to download 2021 April month report, I can download it here and see. And to configure the alerts, I can go here and I can pick a specific API and I can select some matrices that I need to enable. So I will pick this one and then I pick the matrix and the threshold. Then if I add it here, then I can see alerts for these events. Okay, I think that covers the analytics part and all you about API Manager. Then let me quickly go to admin UI and show how new key manager connectivity works. So I can see we are getting a lot of questions. So if I was not able to answer all of them, if I won't be able to answer all these, then we will answer them later when we send mail with the webinar recording. So you can see a key manager section here. This is the one thing I need to highlight. So if you want to add new key manager, you can go here. Then you can provide the name, display name. And here you can see different key managers we do support, Auth0, IWCNV Server, Porto, Pclock, Integrate Octa. So you can select any of these things and provide their configuration, their well-known URL and issuer, consuming key and secret key. Then once you add that here, that will automatically appear as a new key manager. Okay, so I think with that, I think that's enough time for the demonstration. So one quick thing I need to show. So this is Integration Studio. So those who are familiar with Integration Studio, you know you can use this to develop your integration service. So in this one also, I have developed this integration service, and I have deployed this into micro gateway runtime, so which is integration runtime, right? So once I deploy this into integration runtime, so I have already deployed this one. So once you deploy that, you can go to publisher, and in the publisher, when you try to create API, you can see the service catalog option, right? So once you click on this one, you will see the service. So this is the telecom matrices service I developed through the Integration Studio and deployed that into Micro Gateway Runtime. So this, when this is deployed into Micro Integrator Runtime, that will automatically create entry in API Manager Service Catalog. So that is this entry, right? So then you can see, click on this one and see where it runs. So it runs on the MI Runtime and it's having Open API definition. So if you need to convert this integration service into API, you can do that just with the one click. So just like that, you click on this create API and the context and version you need to provide, then you can create API. So just like that, you converted your integration service into API. So if you look at the business requirement, so when you create integration services, it can be streaming or the micro integrator deployed integration service. As API developer, you need to point to these integration services and convert them into API CICD. So this is the this is that capability. So now you can deploy this one like we did before. Then it's deployed. So now we can go ahead and publish this API. So just like that, with a few button clicks, I was able to convert my integration service into a managed API. So again, all this, so within this 1 hour time, like we cannot cover almost all the scenarios. What I tried to do is cover almost all the important features or the new feature that I believe important within this short video, short period of time. So if you're interested, please go to API Manager documentation, and we have documented all these things. And we have new tutorial with all these flows. You can try that as well. So with that, I'll be stopping the demo, and I will try to answer a few more questions. Okay, so there's another question. Do you be recommend going to 264 or skipping 32? So like I mentioned earlier, yes, you can directly move, because we do have all the resources that we need. So then how does the API comment feature work? So I think during the demonstration I addressed that. So basically you can add the comments from the API consumer side, and as API developer, you can respond to them. Okay. Then can we run Stream Integrator alone, or do we need to have API Manager 4.0 integrator running Stream Integrator? So to answer that, yes, you can run Stream Integrator alone. You don't need to have API Manager 4 to connect with that. But if you need to like expose async API and apply quality of services related to API management, then you can always connect, or else you can use that alone. No issue with that. Okay, so then there's another question. Enterprise integration inside. So so question is about whether they can use new API management for the integration. Yes, the answer is yes. So because it's having enterprise integrator runtime, which includes micro integrator and streaming integrator, you can always use them together to build complete use case. So there's another question. Is the API Manager 4 capable for hybrid deployment? Can that act as a self-container? So yes, the answer to that is also yes. So if you want to deploy hybrid deployment and you need to have your data plane in on-premise, then we do support that as well. It can connect to control plane and push API related updates and apply quality of services in the on-premise side, while your control plane can be deployed on the cloud. And also it can be other way as well. We do support both of them. Okay, so then are there any changes in the carbon component in the new version? So the architecture wise, we don't have any changes. So so we will be using the same carbon architecture, component development, all these things will be same. But if we consider the version, we are in this one, we are using different carbon version. So if you have any extensions or anything like that, you will have to bump the version in order to use these capabilities. Okay, so is there any improvement in the performance? Yes, so basically, if you look at the gateway, we have slightly improved the performance and with new JWT authentication methodology also, we have seen a significant gain. So we have published these details in our performance document. So yes, we do have considerable gain in terms of the performance. Okay, so then there's a key manager connection about the key, question about the key manager connectors. Is this a fixed list or can we extend plug? Yes. So for example, if you need to plug issue AD or anything like that, and if they have OAuth 2 interface, what you can do is you can we have our interface, so you can do an implementation based on that. And once you put on that jar into the product distribution, it will auto-populate this UI, and you can see your own key manager type also here. So likewise, you can add the key managers, key manager interfaces, and the implementations in the future. Okay, so then another question, can the API Pro work with the brokers like the Enterprise Integrator can? Yeah, so from now on, Enterprise Integrator is also part of this one. So if you want to connect message brokers, then ideal way would be connecting Enterprise Integrator, which is like the micro integrator or the streaming integrator, then fund those services with API Manager. So that is what we recommend from now on. Okay, I think we have passed the time. We took 5 more minutes. So I think with that, I'm going to stop. Okay, so I think I would like to thank you all for joining today's webinar. And I hope you get something out of this webinar. And then you can try our product and start consuming the API Manager. And if you have any questions, you can always reach to us. Please use our Slack channel to communicate with us if you have any problems. And here I'll put my LinkedIn in the chat. So if you have anything that you need to discuss, you can contact me. And so I think we answered 22 different questions, but I think we all together we got more than 50 questions. So I'm sorry we didn't have enough time to answer all of them, but I promise we note all of these questions and answer them when we send the webinar recording to you all. Okay, thank you everyone. Thanks for joining today's webinar.